the church, we're so used, we're so happy to go after the person, but we're not going after the spirit. And that's why folks are walking out of the church doors, because you're after the person, but you're not after the spirit. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood. The spirit can't take possession over him. I'm almost through. It calls him to do three things. The Bible said it calls him to be a mute. Somebody say mute. Mute means to be unable to speak or to communicate. It took possession of his mouth. When the enemy comes in, he wants to take possession of the central location where you can get all kinds of communication. He wants to stop you from even speaking. Let me help you understand something. The enemy wants to stop you from even voicing what's going on the inside. The enemy will have you in a warped place. And what's going on with our young people today? We're warped. We think don't nobody understand. And glory to God, the church has had a part in that as well. Because folks that we go to talk to when we need help, their motives are incorrect.
Surfaces. It tossed him
on the ground to hard surfaces, inflicting bodily pain and injury. The enemy wants to get you to a place where you hurt yourself. And when you hurt yourself, you don't just hurt yourself, but you hurt those that are connected to you. Look at your neighbor and say, I need Jesus. I need Jesus because this thing is trying to kill me. It calls him to foam at the mouth and gnash at his teeth, and it will cause seizures and convulsions. It was the result of a neurological effect on the brain. That means that the enemy wants to get into your mind. Glory to God. But young people, tell your neighbor, God stopped my funeral.
Started tearing and wearing.